Today I'm going to calculate the length of the belt in the cross belt rack. The outcome for this session is student will able to know how to calculate the length of the cross belt rack. In the last video, I'm showing the driver shaft and driven shaft and some pulleys are to be placed and you have to calculate. We're going through all the details, so the length of the belt, length in contact with the belt, length of the belt which is not in contact with the belt, length of the belt in contact with the smaller pulley, bigger pulley, the distance between the two shafts, the calculated value of alpha, sine alpha, cos alpha. So when you have to calculate using all these values, now for the continuations of this last video, you have to going for using some mathematical problem and to calculate the exact length of the cross belt rack. So for that, pause this video and think this equation, because you can use this equation for calculating the exact length of that belt. The question is, what is the expansion of a plus b raised to n, where n is a positive rational number? Think over that. Now, the answer for this one is, by the binomial expansion, a plus b raised to n is equal to a raised to n plus n into a raised to n minus 1 into b raised to 1 plus n into n minus 1 upon 2 factorial into a raised to n minus 2 into b square plus 1. As you know that here, sine square alpha plus cos square alpha is equal to 1. Therefore, cos square alpha is equal to 1 minus sine square alpha. Or cos alpha is equal to root 1 minus sine square alpha. 1 minus sine square alpha. Or cos alpha is equal to 1 minus sine square alpha raised to 1 by 2. Or you have to write cos alpha is equal to, or cos alpha is equal to 1 minus 1 by 2 sine square alpha by the binomial expansion, as per the binomial expansion. Cos alpha is equal to 1 minus 1 by 2 sine square alpha. Now put this value in the above length. Another thing is that when summation of both the radius, summation of both radius is very small and length of distance between the pulley are large, therefore sine alpha is equal to alpha nearly, as these both radius, this R1 and R2, are very small and the distance between the two pulley or the two shafts is larger one. This value of C is small one. So sine alpha is equal to alpha. So now what is the value of sine alpha? This is the value for cos alpha. It is denoted by 4. Now what is the value of sine alpha? Sine alpha means O1G divided by this length C, this alpha is there. So sine alpha is equal to O1G upon C, this distance, O1G. What is the value of O1G? It is a R1. O1G is equal to O1D plus DG divided by C. What is the value of O1D? O1D means R1 plus DG means it is R2, this distance, it is parallel one. This one is this, it is R2. So R1 by R2 by C. So sine alpha is equal to R1 plus R2 by C. As alpha is very small, or alpha is equal to sine inverse R1 plus R2 by C. R1 plus R2 by C. But alpha is very small, so sine alpha is equal to alpha. Therefore, alpha is equal to R1 plus R2 by C. This is a fifth notation. Now you know the value of alpha, you know the value of sine alpha, you know the value of cos alpha. Now put this value in the length of the belt. Where? Here. What is the value of length of L? Length of L is equal to pi into R1 plus R2. Length L is equal to pi into bracket R1 plus R2 plus 2 alpha. What is the value of alpha? Alpha is R1 plus R2 by C. It is a 2 alpha. So plus 2 into bracket, put the value of alpha, that is R1 plus R2 by C. R1 plus R2 by C into R1 plus R2. R1 plus R2 plus C cos alpha plus C. What is the value of cos alpha? Just know how to calculate. Cos alpha is equal to 1 minus 1 by 2 sine square alpha. Cos alpha 1 minus 1 by 2 sine square alpha. It is cos alpha is 1 minus 1 by 2 sine square alpha. We have to put the value. Now multiply it. Length L is equal to pi into bracket R1 plus R2 plus 2 into bracket 2 R1 plus R2 bracket square by C plus here in the previous one. When you multiply it, L is equal to pi 2 alpha R1, 2 is length AB pi R2 plus 2 alpha R2. So it is equal to, length is equal to pi R1 2 alpha R1 C cos alpha plus pi R2 2 alpha 2. So when you have to C cos alpha, you have to put the value of C cos alpha here, that is C into bracket so and so. So it is 1 minus C minus C into bracket 1 minus 1 by 2 instead of sine square alpha, it is a alpha is sine alpha is equal to alpha 1 1 minus 1 by 2 square alpha. So length of total in pi into bracket R1 plus R2 plus 2 into bracket R1 plus R2 bracket square by C plus C into bracket 1 minus, you have to put the value of alpha. What is the value of alpha? Value of alpha is R1 plus R2 by C. R1 plus R2 by C bracket square. It is a value. It is value of alpha. R1 plus R2 by C. So length L is equal to pi into bracket R1 plus R2 plus 2 into bracket R1 plus R2 bracket square by C plus C minus, this C square get cancelled here. C and C square get cancelled here. It is equal to R1 plus R2 bracket square by C. So length of belt L is equal to pi into bracket R1 plus R2 plus R1 plus R2, R1 plus R2 get cancelled here. In the previous one, then you have to multiply with a 2 1 here with a 2 C cos alpha pi R1, R1 plus R2 length is equal to 2 pi R2, length is equal to C cos alpha, AB is equal to, so it is a 2 C cos alpha, 2 C cos alpha. Here it is also 2 C cos alpha, here it is a 2 C cos alpha, it is a 2 C. So 2c, and here 2 get cancelled here, r1 plus r2 bracket square by c. So pi into length is equal to pi r1 plus r2 plus r1 plus r2 square, and r1 get cancelled here. It is r1 plus r2 bracket square by c plus 2c. So therefore, length of cross belt drive is equal to pi into bracket r1 plus r2 plus r1 plus r2 bracket square by c plus 2c. So it is a it is a formula to calculate the exact length of cross belt drive. So here the total length of belt is AED, then D to C, then CFB and B to A. So it is a total length of cross belt drive. So to calculate the total length of cross belt drive, L is equal to pi into R1 plus R2 plus R1 plus R2 bracket square by C plus 2C. So this is the formula to calculate the exact length of cross belt drive. Reference is Basic Mechanical Engineering by Singal.